Questions?
Yes.
All right. Questions? Oh, Mike has a question.
Dave, sorry. Say, the end of the Debussy Rhapsody.
Yeah.
What do you feel in terms of keeping the tempo up as well as playing, whether the dot, dot, dot? Okay, so D natural instead of the D sharp.
Yeah, you can play. This one version is, I don't like this.
Yeah, the other.
I know the upper position
right,
is this
yeah,
one,
yeah.
But I like.
Go.
Yeah.
Sorry, I read that you worked on my firm sign, and I just want to know what
stand up and yell your question.
I read that you played with Leonard Bernstein,
yeah.
And I wanted to know if there are any highlights or what.
Oh, yes, of course. Oh, very, yeah. I was in Vienna. I studied in Vienna. And I played, my teacher was in Vienna Philharmonic, Peter Schmiedl. Now he retired. And he always invited his student to the recordings and concerts with Vienna Philharmonic. And that was a session, he played the Mahler symphonies, all series with Bernstein. And I played fifth, sixth, 18th clarinet, just I was there. It was not important, but I was there. And I could see how he worked, yeah. And, we waited in the concert house in Vienna. We waited for him. 10 o'clock was the session, or 11 o'clock. 10 passed, 20 passed, he didn't come. And the people said, the flute player, Wolfgang Schulz, he was a solo flute, last year he died. He said to the concertmaster, hey, in Viennese dialect, yeah, what is my maestro? Where is the maestro? The whole orchestra was waiting. And then 20 passed, you can hear, it's coming. And he came, and his friend was there. He had a young boyfriend, and he was serving his tablet with a whiskey, and then he was. And then we saw him coming in the music friend was coming in, and he was over the. Hey guys, which one we do today? Which one? Which symphony? Yeah. And it was amazing. He brought the Mahler back to Europe. It was really common. Yeah? And Mahler was in Vienna, but then long time they didn't play Mahler. And when Bernstein came to Vienna, he reanimated him, yeah, in Vienna. So the sixth step, it was in the 70s. They played, they used to play Mahler all the time. Yeah? So, and during the, he said something, everybody was listening. It was no noise, they're listening. Because he was not, like a guy who know 100% the partitur, and he said, oh, yeah, da-da-da-da. No, he knows 100% the partitur, the music. But then he brought over in a very, very simple way, yeah? He said, oh, come on, this time, Vienna Philharmonic had no girls, no women in the orchestra. That's mean, you know what I mean. Then he spoke about this language, with this language to the orchestra, yeah? Hey, come on, play that, you know, I don't want to say here, but whatever, he said really very simple words, but we 100% understand what he means. Mahler is so contrastful, so many contrasts, yeah? In one second, one, many contrasts at the same time. So he brought out, it was really amazing. So, and we had a tour it was Athens, Greek. I was with them, and we had been in the bar with the clarinet section. At 3 o'clock in the morning, suddenly he came from, hey guys, what do you think? He invited us all. He was very human, very, very friendly to everybody. But he could, if he didn't get what he want, he was, hey man, hey, what you doing here? I go out, let's make a break. So. He was also like this, but the result was fantastic. I think this series on the market, this Mahler symphonies. I mean, this is an old recording. There are so many new recordings after. It doesn't mean it's better. Now it's better. It's not the way, the new recordings are better. Sometimes I like the old much more, you know, because after a while you want to make it more interesting as it is. Yeah? And this is a misunderstanding from many. If you play 1,000 times the Mozart clarinet concert, you want to make it with more articulation, more ornaments and more echo to make it interesting. But it is interesting, it's composed interesting. So we don't need to make it better. It is perfect, yeah. So do something is good, but not too much. Yeah? That means this is also many conductors. I'm sorry to say, but they listen so many. I know that all conductors I know, everybody knows Carlos Kleiber, of course. But I think you will say, he conducts like Carlos Kleiber. It's imitation of Carlos Kleiber. But in a way, you can, if you do it well, some movings, why not? It's not a copy, it's just you take over the best things and then you can bring it out if it works in the music. Yeah? We had one situation, we played the Ma Mère Loire, and it was in Taipei with Berlin Philharmonic, and it was always never together. The beginning is not so easy, you have to bring it together. And Simon was singing, and it, blah, blah, blah. And then the first violin player said, behind them. With Karian, it was never a problem. With Karian, it was never a problem. And Simon could hear this. Okay, then he... It was together. It was together. It's very easy to bring this wave. You have to conduct like the following music. Not now I start. It starts before. This is it. And that's what Bernstein is. It's an outstanding. All the Harvard, or he made many speeches.
Harvard lectures.
Harvard. Yeah. It was interesting. Everybody was. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I mean, yeah. I had not so many experiences, just this. And I listened many concerts in Vienna when I was in Vienna. Yeah.
Yeah. One other question, just set up. What mouthpiece, ligature, barrel, clarinet do you play, and do you change it when you play chamber music or as a solo? What do you do differently?
No, I have, I play maybe 50% wooden reeds.
Reed, yeah.
And 50% the leger. But important is the combination. Yeah.
Like the mouthpiece.
The mouthpiece combination and the reed. So if you take, for example, P40 Van Doren, I have a Viennese mouthpiece. It's more narrow. That means I have a German clarinet, Wurlitzer. German board, German, normal German clarinet with a Viennese mouthpiece. And this is more narrow, long open, not narrow. That means you need strong reeds, otherwise it goes through. And this is, for a plastic reed, it's better because if you have a P40, P45, you take a plastic reed. Of course, if you have an open, you have to have a very thin, soft reed. Mm-hmm. And if the plastic reed is too soft, it has no power. Mm-hmm. Yeah? We can take a strong plastic reed, and there's more center in this sound. That's why I think it's very hard. It doesn't work 100% in the French mouthpiece. They're all fighting. They say, yeah, but it's not stable enough. And
the ligature has to be really tight too to keep it from moving.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. A ligature I always change. Now I got a ligature from him. From it's a Silverstein. And it's great, but I have so many. I changed the mouthpieces sometimes.
Collection, yeah.
And every mouthpiece has a different reaction to the ligatures. I try to find a good combination. This mouthpiece works the best with this ligature or with this one. Yeah. So that's why I sometimes change. So I'm not fixed only this or only. I have a mouthpiece from Nicky Kückmeier. If somebody's interested, I have some mouthpieces here. Yeah. And P2, play easy P2, and play easy P3, and M. And for example, Anthony McGill, he plays a P2 from Nick with wooden reeds. This play easy theory, you can play with plastic reed and with wood. Yeah. Yeah. So if somebody, when anybody wants to try, I have here, and after we can. And the other question is in the chamber music or in the orchestra. I had a reed. It was a plastic reed.
Signature, right? Signature Legere, or which Legere do you play?
It's a Viennese cut.
Oh, Viennese cut.
It's a little bit different.
Yeah,
and it's smaller and it's different. Yeah, mm-hmm. And this was 1 year old. I played everything, solo concert, orchestra pieces, everything, yeah? But in two weeks ago, I was in Japan. I played the Strauss concertino with this reed, and then after the people came for signing, and I had this reed case. I have to put it in, but I didn't put it in. I put it on, yeah? And yes, it's signed.
French.
I put it back through, close it, and I opened it in Berlin. I wanted to play with the same reed. Open it. It was over. It was like this. And then I come. It was gone.
Reed clipper.
I was very sad about this because 1 year. It was fantastic. Yeah. Never changed.
Yeah.
But normally I look for a reed that gives me the possibility to play everything. Yeah. To play chamber music, play orchestra, because I want to have a reed even in the chamber music. With no limit, yeah. So it depends. For example, for Bruckner, I like very much the wooden reed. For example, Bruckner is so this body, yeah. And I like if the sound is a little bit woody, not woodo, woody sound. It's nice for Bruckner, yeah. For Debussy, if you have, I don't like so much. Very clean. And the plastic reed is very clean, and what is not always necessary, of course clean, but you have to have a good, to make everything under control. Even you play, you break out, but you have to break out when you want, not with your control, yeah? So that everybody can hear, oh, now he break out, but not the other hand that he breaks out, that you can feel he doesn't want. But it has to give you all the controls in every register. I think for me it's important. Yeah?
More questions? Yes.
On your synthetic reed, are you able to work the reed or do you just find synthetic reed so you find
synthetic? Synthetic reed? Synthetic reed. Yeah. I never changed. I didn't try, but Legere, I met Legere, Guy Legere, last week in New York. He was there, and he told me to change with a wrapper, with a paper is not good, but with a knife you can change a little bit. I never did it.
You can clip twice. Yeah. Legeres can clip twice if I've had students and done
it. They can change a little bit.
About two times you can clip it. If it starts to get soft,
yes,
you can clip.
Yes, you mean cut.
Yeah.
Clip,
yeah. Yeah.
This is okay, but with a paper, it's
no,
not good.
No.
You can do it with a knife.
Sometimes you could boil it.
Huh?
You could boil it.
Yeah.
To make it softer.
Yeah. But I don't change. I look for a reed. Somebody said, oh, but it's 20 euro. It's nothing if it's work.
It's deductible. Yeah.
It's cheap.
Problems, how did you
setbacks?
Get through any setbacks as a student? Sometimes sitting in practice rooms for hours, you can't seem to get something just right.
Yeah.
And you sort of put yourself down. How did you get through those rough times as a student?
Oh, yucky. yeah, this time, as a student, but you have the same problem also in this age. Yeah. Open your case and it doesn't work, and then you get boring. Frustrated. But then I learned from this. I'm sure if you work on and go continuous in this frustrated time, it's better to go out, drink a beer, go out and believe on you that next day, I'm sure the next day is better. Sunrise next day. Don't make it, then, yes, to make you crazy. And you work, and then maybe you make the opposite. You break every reed,
yeah.
Because then you have no motivation, and the reed and everything is the motivation. If the body is in a good shape, you know, then many reeds are working. If your body is not good shape, you have no temperature, no air, and then is the problem what I said before, with less air, the problem in the reed is like an elephant. Yeah. So I think it's you have to be free and then believe on it. Next day, I'm sure it's gone. It's good like yesterday, not today. Yeah. Because if it's yesterday was good and today is not good, it's not the reed fault. Maybe it's you. Yeah. Why should the reed say no, today? Today is Thursday. Today I don't like. So I'm sure that it's just sunrise next day. Or you mean also when you get in a nervous situation, or
you
come down and you have a very difficult next week with solo concert, Niels concert, Fonseca concert, or something like this, and how to prepare? Yeah, I think everybody is the same. I did also to come down. I tried many things, yoga, or I did yoga. But then I stopped again because I couldn't take the yoga. Yet it was too silent for me. I couldn't do it. I stopped yoga and then I did sport. For me, it's very good to make sport, to run in the wood, just a walk in the wood. And before the concert, sometimes people ask me, what do you before the solo concert, before you have a big solo backstage? Because the mentality is very different. Somebody makes atem technique, breathing technique. Oh, close the eyes. Of course, important is to come down, because if you're nervous, you're flying. Yeah? Mm-hmm. You're like when you're in the swing, and then it's no control anymore. The fingers are not good, the sound is not good, so come down, and sometimes it's just one moment. Just breathe out, take time, one bar, and then start again. And I'm sure it's much better. Not always, but normally, yeah. But I think for me, it's nice to have, because I have very nice friends in my orchestra, and we have a lot of fun together. We meet also privately, and before we go on the stage, we have fun. We are in a good mood. Everybody not, let's drink something. Not alcohol, the time is gone. It was before. There are some last, many.
That's afterwards.
They play trombone, right?
Horn.
Oh, horn.
Horn.
They probably need that.
Horn. No, but I like very much to communicate before I go on the stage with my friends. Then you don't think too much. Mm-hmm. I think for me, it's good.
Do you have a favorite type of music? Like, do you like to play orchestra better, or chamber music, or solo, or everything?
I like the mixture. When I play only solo, I miss the symphonies. I like to play the opera. It's fantastic to play opera. It's the most beautiful combination with singers. Yeah, that's why we have to combine, to forget the clarinet, to try to make a way of a singer. And there's so many songs when you play, and not doodle 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 doodle. It is not important. Yeah. So this is, the question is, I like everything. If you have the possibility, that's good.
Anyone? All right, well, let's get Wenzel Fuchs.